Greetings, welcome back to another edition of Then and Now, a series where I take a look at classic video games and compare them with the latest release, remake, or reimagining. In this edition of Then and Now, I'll be comparing the cancelled Killer Instinct prototypes on the Xbox 360 and Killer Instinct Anniversary Edition on the Xbox Series X. 2024 marks the 30th anniversary of
Killer Instinct,
and I'll be sharing some of my Killer Instinct memories. Killer Instinct Season 1 and the Xbox 360 prototypes were developed by Double Helix Games, published by Microsoft Studios. Killer Instinct Anniversary Edition was developed by Iron Galaxy, published by Microsoft Studios. Killer Instinct was an arcade fighting game released in 1994. It was developed by Rare, published by Midway Games, licensed by Nintendo. Killer Instinct had an
insane combo
system conceptualized by Ken Lobb. If you've played 007 GoldenEye on the Nintendo 64, there's a weapon called the Clob, and it's named after Ken Lobb. Ken Lobb also made an appearance as one of the armed civilians in 007 GoldenEye as well. Thanks to Midway's DCS sound system, Killer Instinct Arcade had
godlike
stereophonic audio. Killer Instinct had a
Hyper
announcer voiced by Chris Sutherland. The soundtrack was
awesome.
It was composed by Robin Beanland and Graham Norgate. Powered by Silicon Graphics computers, Killer Instinct featured a cast of 3D pre-rendered combatants. It was the first arcade fighting game to have a built-in hard drive. The characters were motion captured by Killer Instinct artist Kevin Bayless using a real-time motion tracking sensor called Flock of Birds. Here's a fun fact. Jago was the first test character designed for the motion capture process. Jago's hairstyle and high kicks were based on Kevin Bayless. Follow Kevin on X, formerly known as Twitter, and Twitch.tv for more behind-the-scenes Rare trivia.
Available for your home in 1995, only on Nintendo Ultra 64.
Unfortunately, in 1995, the Nintendo Ultra 64 was delayed. To keep the fans satisfied, the developers at Rare created an incredibly faithful 16-bit translation of Killer Instinct for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System and the Nintendo Game Boy. I've been a fan of Killer Instinct since Killer Instinct Gold on the Nintendo 64. The game was released here in Asia in 1997, almost a year after its North American release. As a little kid, I wanted a Nintendo 64 for my birthday just to play Killer Instinct Gold, and when I finally got it, I absolutely loved it. After Killer Instinct Gold, the series was put on hold, and I was waiting with bated breath that one day a sequel will unfold. Well, the years start coming, and they don't stop coming. On September 24th, 2002, Microsoft acquired Rare, and they became a first-party developer for the Xbox. For many years, Rare and Microsoft Studios teased Killer Instinct 3 in games like Grabbed by the Ghoulies for the original Xbox, Conquer Live and Reloaded for the original Xbox, Viva Piñata Trouble in Paradise for the Xbox 360, and Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts for the Xbox 360. In Grabbed by the Ghoulies, there's a bookshelf full of video games, and one of those games is KI3. If you leave the controller on standby in Conker Live and Reloaded, Conker will pull out a faux Xbox handheld and play KI3.
Oh, I can believe that!
In Viva Pinata, you can use the Xbox Live Vision camera and scan the three Killer Instinct cards to unlock an exclusive KI Pinata. In Banjo-Kazooie, you can talk to Mambo and purchase Full Gore's arm for your vehicle. You can also ask Bottles about Killer Instinct 3. The Lord of Games nonchalantly mentions the new Killer Instinct. And the Jolly Dodger opens a briefcase full of KI3. In 2007, Rare released a Christmas card for the fans, but if you pay close attention, you'll see KI3 embroidered on one of the Christmas stockings. It almost felt like an ongoing dialogue between the developers and the fans. They knew we wanted Killer Instinct 3, and this was their way of acknowledging the fans. The Killer Instinct franchise would remain dormant for 17 years until June 11th, 2013. During the Microsoft press conference at E3, Killer Instinct was officially announced as an Xbox One exclusive. Killer Instinct would be a day one launch title and the first fighting game on the next generation consoles. I couldn't believe it. After years of speculation and rumors, the announcement of a new Killer Instinct reinvigorated my love for the series. In late 2013, I was studying in the States. I told one of my best friends from college, Joseph, about the new Killer Instinct. He and I drove to Hartford, Connecticut to attend the Microsoft Xbox One pre-launch event. Microsoft had multiple kiosks and a playable pre-release build of Killer Instinct. It was so much fun. The first time I played the new Killer Instinct, I thought, wow, this is the Killer Instinct I've been imagining for 17 years. Once again, Killer Instinct was the reason why I purchased a new video game console. Whenever I play the new Killer Instinct, it always brings me back to my college days. Good times. The new Killer Instinct was built on the Hex engine, a proprietary game engine developed by Double Helix Games. Hex engine originated from the Xbox exclusive game Buffy the Vampire Slayer, based on the television series. Killer Instinct was initially developed as a cross-generational Xbox Live arcade game for both the Xbox 360 and the Xbox One. Unfortunately, the Xbox 360 version was cancelled during development. Double Helix Games and Microsoft Studios focused their efforts on pushing the boundaries of the next generation Xbox hardware with new gameplay mechanics while staying true to Killer Instinct's roots. In February 2014, 2.5 months after the launch of Killer Instinct Season 1, Amazon acquired Double Helix Games. Iron Galaxy, a Chicago-based game developer with a massive pedigree in fighting games, took over the development of Killer Instinct. Thanks to an anonymous benefactor from Ultratech, I'll be taking an extensive look at two Killer Instinct Xbox 360 prototypes. But before I do, let's talk about the basics of Killer Instinct. The Killer Instinct tournament is organized into rounds. Each player will start the round with two life bars. The player that depletes both of their opponent's life bars will win the game. Each time you hit your opponent with light attacks, medium attacks, heavy attacks, special attacks, or throws, their life bar will decrease. When the opponent's first life bar is dropped to zero, there will be a brief pause. The fighter who lost their energy gets up off the ground and back to rise with a replenished second life bar. When the opponent's second life bar is in a danger state, you can perform an
Ultra Combo!
Ultra Combos are an extravagant and effective way to finish a fight. Fighting games are all about movement. Movement is an important part of controlling the flow of combat. Maintaining the optimal distance from your opponent is a crucial skill that must be learned.
Show no mercy.
In the original Killer Instinct, you can perform a danger move, an ultimate, a humiliation, or a stage knockoff. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, you can perform ultimates and stage ultras. Combos are the core of Killer Instinct. The combo system is what made Killer Instinct viable, accessible, and fun to play after all these years. A combo is a sequence of linked attacks. Pressing the right combination of directional and button inputs in quick succession will unleash a combo. In Killer Instinct, there's a rhythmic pacing to the button presses. You can start to zone in with flurries and combinations. The resulting combo that you see on the screen depends on the sequence of attacks you perform. Basic combos in Killer Instinct follow a structure: opener, auto, linker, auto, ender. Openers are special attacks or shadow attacks that can start combos. A jump attack can be used as an opener. After an opener, any attack button will start an auto combo. An auto combo is a chain of two attacks that are automatically executed from a single button press. As soon as you perform an auto, you can perform a linker, a special attack that can extend your combo. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, if you hold down the light or medium attack button, you'll perform a heavy linker. A light linker hits once. A medium linker hits twice. And a heavy linker hits three times. The final element in a basic combo is an ender. An ender is a hard-hitting attack that finishes the combo. The damage of the ender is determined by the length of your combo. You can perform an ender by executing a heavy special attack. Make sure to end your combos in battle to maximize your damage. Shadow attacks are extra powerful versions of special attacks. Shadow attacks were introduced in Killer Instinct 2 and Killer Instinct Gold. Shadow attacks can do more damage than special attacks, and certain shadow attacks gain special properties. You can also perform shadow attacks during a combo. It's important to remember that shadow attacks are extremely useful outside of combos, so it becomes a mind game. Do I want to inflict more damage to my opponent, or do I want the utility of the shadow attack? It adds another layer of complexity to the game. In the Xbox 360 prototype, the amount of damage taken is displayed as a dark orange bar on the opponent's life bar. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, the amount of damage taken is now known as potential damage. As you perform autos in your combo, potential damage builds up, and it's displayed as a white bar on the opponent's life bar. The most important aspect of potential damage is that the damage is not dealt unless you perform an ender to your combo. Combo limit is a meter that governs how long you can do combos. The meter is displayed below the combo hit counter. With every consecutive hit, the meter fills up from a green bar, a yellow bar, to a red bar. If you reach the combo limit and don't perform an ender, your opponent will fall out of your combo and you won't deal any potential damage. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, there are four small squares under the combo limit meter. This is the knockdown value. As you perform autos or linkers, the squares will gradually fill up, and each square represents the combo ender level. The higher the ender level, the more hits you'll get out of the ender, and the more damage it will inflict.
Combo Breaker!
At the heart of Killer Instinct is the
Combo Breaker!
The two-way interaction between the attacker and the defender is a philosophy that makes Killer Instinct unique. If my opponent is performing a relentless barrage of combos on my character, I have a chance to break out of my opponent's combos. Timing and being able to react is key. The window of opportunity to break out of a combo depends on the strength of the attack. For instance, if the attacker is using heavy auto attacks to maximize damage, the window of opportunity to break out of a combo is high, as heavy attacks are slower and easier to react. If the attacker is using light auto attacks at the cost of less damage, the window of opportunity to break out of the combo is small, as light attacks are faster and more difficult to react. Combo breakers change the dynamics of the match. It changes the positioning and spacing of the characters. It can also influence your next setup.
Lockout!
Locking out your opponent is vital to big damage in Killer Instinct. The
Lockout
will prevent the player from performing another combo breaker for 3 seconds. If the color of the X above your character is orange, you mistimed the combo breaker. If the color of the X is red, you used the wrong strength of the combo breaker. It's a little ambiguous because you're not exactly sure what strength of the attack locked you out and how much longer it's gonna last. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, the lockout indicator was redesigned as a timer. It now displays what strength was used and when the lockout is going to end. Once you understand the core mechanics of Killer Instinct, you can come up with the most insane combos. Killer Instinct encourages player creativity in playstyles. There's a lot of depth, freedom, and flexibility in its combo system. The developers have given us the tools. We create the artwork.
Killer Instinct.
This is the Killer Instinct Xbox 360 title screen. For those of you who've played Killer Instinct Season 1 10 years ago, this should bring back some memories. The reimagined Killer Instinct theme by video game composer Mick Gordon immediately gets you in the mood to start kicking ass. These two Killer Instinct Xbox 360 title screens look almost identical, but you may notice the second prototype has a much darker contrast. The background is predominantly dark, and I like how the flames illuminate the letters K and I. This is the Killer Instinct Anniversary Edition title screen. The new color scheme and logo pays homage to Killer Instinct Gold. Purple is my favorite color. It's not just a color, it's an attitude. Each season of Killer Instinct had an artistic theme and a new aesthetic direction based on the story. The Xbox 360 prototype and Season 1 represented the return of Killer Instinct. The aesthetic direction of Killer Instinct Season 2 was the rise of Ultratech. The artistic theme of Killer Instinct Season 3 was the arrival of the Shadow Lord Gargos and his minions. Pressing the start button on the Xbox 360 prototype will engulf the screen in a blazing inferno. Pressing the menu button on Killer Instinct Anniversary will make the logo explode. This is the Killer Instinct Xbox 360 main menu. Once again, these two prototypes look almost identical, but there are a few differences and omissions. There are 8 modes to choose from in the first prototype, while the second prototype has 6 modes. Selecting single player in the first prototype will bring out a list of modes available: arcade, practice, and training. Selecting local play in the second prototype will bring out a list of modes available: versus, survival, dojo, and practice. Achievements, leaderboards, and downloadable content from the first prototype have been replaced with Fight Archive and KI Store. The second prototype has a player banner along with the Trials menu on the right side. The player banner displays the gamertag, an icon, the amount of killer points available, online ranking, and a taunt. Trials are in-game challenges given to the player. Completing them will reward the player with killer points, which you can use to unlock characters, backgrounds, and various in-game content. If we go into options and select controller configuration, the first prototype does not have a setting to remap all 3 punches or kicks as one button. In the second prototype, there are more controller configuration options. This is the Killer Instinct Anniversary Edition main menu. When Iron Galaxy took over development duties for Killer Instinct, the designers completely updated and streamlined the user interface. Ultratech's influence and the power of Gargos has made navigating and interacting with the menus more intuitive. Killer Instinct Anniversary Edition represents the culmination of Iron Galaxy's ongoing development and the 10th anniversary since its release on the Xbox One.
Welcome.
This is the Killer Instinct Xbox 360 character select screen. This is the Killer Instinct Anniversary Edition Fighter Select Screen. There are 4 characters in the first prototype and 6 characters in the second prototype. Killer Instinct Anniversary has a total of 29 fighters, which include guest characters from other video game franchises like
Rash
from Battletoads,
Arbiter
from Halo,
General Rom
from Gears of War. In the first prototype, Thunder's character model is incomplete. In the second prototype, Thunder's character model is almost complete. Glacius in the second prototype appears as an elongated character model of Jago. It will haunt my dreams forever. When you highlight Orchid in the second prototype, she appears in her fighting stance, but there are graphical anomalies. Sadira's character model is also unfinished, and she wears a mask similar to her first character reveal trailer. Sadira does not wear a mask in her final design. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, highlighting a fighter's portrait will display their silhouette and insignia. Selecting a fighter will show off their unique personality. You can also select various color palettes, customized presets, and retro-inspired costumes. In the Xbox 360 prototypes, highlighting certain stages will display concept art by West Studio. If you want to see more amazing Killer Instinct concept art, please visit weststudio.com. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, highlighting a stage will display a video vignette.
Fight on!
Here's a comparison of the versus screens. So, let's break it down. In the first prototype, names of the characters are displayed at the bottom of the screen. Concept art showcases the stage. A Kiai shout can be heard. In the second prototype, names of the characters are displayed at the top of the screen. The characters appear, and the versus screen fades to red. The player banner is displayed at the bottom of the screen. The announcer says,
"Fight on!"
In Killer Instinct Anniversary, the versus screen was completely redesigned. The versus font resembles the Killer Instinct logo, and the overall color scheme resembles Killer Instinct Gold.
Ready! Fight!
Now, let's compare the pre-fight and victory font styles.
Ready! Fight! Ready! Fight! Perfect! Perfect! Awesome victory! Perfect! Awesome victory! Time out! Draw! Time out! Draw!
In my personal opinion, I prefer the fonts in the Xbox 360 prototype. It's aggressive, it's visually striking, and it complements the artistic direction of the game. In the Xbox 360 prototype, the combo counter has a red blood splatter. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, the combo counter has a purple blood splatter. In the Xbox 360 prototype, the first life bar is reminiscent of the original Killer Instinct arcade game. It's a combination of green and yellow colors. The word Ultra is displayed on the second life bar, letting both players know that an Ultra can be performed. Character face icons are placed beside the life bars. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, the life bars were remastered and redesigned. The first life bar is bright green, and the word
Danger
is located above the opponent's second life bar, letting both players know that health is low and an ultra can be performed. The life bars now have a shimmer effect that shines across. Character face icons are a lot more prominent, and they change depending on whether the player is using a custom color, an alternate costume, or a customized preset. When you defeat your opponent in the Xbox 360 prototype, their life bar remains on screen. When you defeat your opponent in Killer Instinct Anniversary, their life bar slides off screen.
Shadows!
In the Xbox 360 prototype, the shadow meters on the bottom left and bottom right side of the screen are blue in color. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, Iron Galaxy redesigned the shadow meters. The colors have changed from blue to purple. The word shadow is labeled beside the meters. I should mention that the Xbox 360 prototypes are not fully optimized, and I've had an occasional
lockout
on my Xbox 360. So, to prevent another
lockout,
I'll show you all the special attacks and shadow attacks of the Core 4 Killer Instinct characters.
Jago!
Harnessing the power of the Tiger Spirit, Jago wages a constant internal battle to avoid the Spirit's dark corruption. Jago's past struggles have him gripped in a crisis of faith, which shows in his weathered, embattled look. Clothed in tapestry from the tiger's lair, he clings to a solemn search for answers. Much like the original arcade game, Jago was the first character being worked on for the new Killer Instinct. Though his appearance and moves have been updated, Jago's playstyle and formidable pure energy of faith remain the same.
Saberwolf!
Bristling with hypodermics, but free of Ultratech's cybernetic augmentations, Saberwolf struggles to find a cure to regain his humanity. Alone in the depths of insanity, Saberwolf has descended into unprecedented savagery. With an inhuman, soul-rending howl, the Age of the Wolf has begun. Saberwolf has an elaborate, realistic fur that is completely physics-based, using procedural animation with inverse kinematics. In the Xbox 360 prototype, Saberwolf's Eldritch Light is green. In Killer Instinct Anniversary, Saberwolf's Eldritch Light is blue. Saberwolf's appearance in all the Killer Instinct games is dedicated to the 1984 ZX Spectrum game called Saber Wolf.
Thunder!
Tormented by the mysteries surrounding the alleged death of his brother, Eagle, Thunder is an honorable warrior who respects tradition and fights from his heart. Thunder enters Ultra Tech's tournament, hoping to recover Eagle's remains so that he can be given a traditional burial and both can find peace. There are rumors that Ultra Tech have kidnapped Eagle and plundered his mind, transforming him into the ultimate killing machine,
Fulgor.
In the Xbox 360 prototype, Thunder's moves are functional, but his character model is incomplete. Microsoft Studios, Double Helix, and Iron Galaxy consulted with the Nez Perce tribe in North Central Idaho to evaluate the authenticity of Thunder's redesign. Killer Instinct creative director Ken Lobb provided the voice of Thunder.
Supreme victory! Glacius!
Crash landing in Antarctica, the cold-blooded alien Glacius is determined to find the ones responsible for attacking his ship and the assassin who stole its power core. Glacius is a powerful telepathic being who can summon deadly ice spikes and puddles of cold water. His alien species can adapt to environments easily and turn local resources from any planet into native forms of defense and attack. Getting cold feet? His exoskeleton uses multiple layers of transparency and refraction, along with tens of thousands of physics colliding shards to depict his ice armor and ice constructs. In the Xbox 360 prototype, Glacius has visual issues and his appearance is different from his final design in Killer Instinct Anniversary. Ice to beat you. Character balancing in fighting games are always in constant flux. Over the course of Killer Instinct's development, Iron Galaxy made adjustments to characters' normal moves, special moves, and combos while introducing new abilities. The special moves in the Xbox 360 prototype and Killer Instinct Anniversary may look identical, but the properties as far as damage, frame data, and hitboxes have changed. Although the Xbox 360 prototype is a work in progress, the visuals look great. Jago's character model looks just as good as the Anniversary Edition, albeit not as sharp or as detailed. Some arenas in the prototype are lacking global illumination, real-time lighting, and visual polish, which is understandable. It is nice to see environmental damage as the fight progresses, although there are some visual bugs in the prototype. Killer Instinct Anniversary features all new, next-gen lighting, enhanced visuals, and a new camera system. If both characters walk as far back as possible, the camera slowly zooms out. It's reminiscent of the original Killer Instinct arcade. Killer Instinct Anniversary includes an optional dynamic camera effect. When players perform a level 4 combo ender, the impact of the attacks are shown in multiple cinematic camera angles. The visual upgrades in Anniversary Edition enhance the way you play, watch, and learn Killer Instinct. Here's a comparison of the arenas. The new Killer Instinct announcer is
awesome!
Michael Ouellette, the lead producer of Killer Instinct Season 1, provided the voiceover for Jago and the announcer. The announcer in the Xbox 360 prototype uses different vocal inflections compared to the Anniversary Edition. Let's listen. In the Xbox 360 prototype, Jago has two victory taunts.
I'm afraid your path ends here. Perhaps this was not the path for you.
In Killer Instinct Anniversary, Jago has only one victory taunt.
I'm afraid your path ends here.
Supreme victory! Perfect.
Killer Instinct features an interactive music system. Background music dynamically adapts to every button press by the players. It's really awesome. It almost feels like the players are conducting the music during the fight. If the player successfully lands a 15-hit combo or more, the background music changes to the first 8 bars of the recurring beat. Activating a character's instinct will trigger mono layers of musical flourishes that overshadow the background music. It gives the player a sense that their character is getting stronger during the fight. If both players leave the characters on standby, the background music crossfades into a slower tempo. If both players move the characters around the arena, the background music crossfades into an upbeat tempo. Here's an Easter egg. If both players leave the characters on standby long enough, the background music crossfades into the original Killer Instinct character theme by Robin Beanland. If you pause the game and press up or down to highlight an option, you will hear melodies of the Killer Instinct theme. Every character has a melody for their ULTRA! Samples of the background music are synchronized to the character's attacks with the appropriate musical beat. The Ultra Combo's adaptive audio in the Xbox 360 prototype is slightly different from Killer Instinct Anniversary.
Ultra! Awesome victory!
And now for something completely different. In Forza Horizon 5, you can fully customize and personalize your car with a variety of car horns. One of those legendary musical horns is the Killer Instinct theme. In the summer 2016 film, Captain Fantastic, starring Academy-nominated actor Viggo Mortensen, there is a scene where kids are playing Killer Instinct featuring Jago and Saberwolf. But if you pay close attention, the kids are actually playing the prototype build. Take a look at the life bars and the character face icons. They are the same life bars and character icons in the Xbox 360 prototype. Killer Instinct was released on the Xbox One in 2013, just 2.5 years before Captain Fantastic hit theaters in 2016. So why did Microsoft Studios provide the filmmakers footage of the prototype instead of the final build? We may never know. Thanks for watching this
Ultra!
Edition of Then and Now. See you next time.